guess my game froze. I don't know what that was about. High score, right? I hope it wasn't out of focus that whole time. I'm sorry, guys. Just realized it wasn't even focused on the screen. Yeah, I haven't gotten very far. I just picked up DX recently. Otherwise, I had the regular version. Also, I haven't played in a while. I don't have a sword. I don't know what that's about. Yeah, there is some pretty noticeable tearing when the screen changes, but I mean beyond that, oops. I don't think there's any real issues with this game on here. Battery died in my game. Whoops. There we go. Thank you. only that were the opposite. That's enough of that. I'll play this all night otherwise. I bet this game has a super long intro, doesn't it? There's some tearing on that, as I bet you can see. Not so much there, though. Something interesting I just noticed on the camera, it looks like the top of these text boxes are cut off, but from the angle I'm playing at, they really aren't. If someone comes up, I'll shift and show you. But I suppose... Sorry, guys. Phone overheated, which I guess didn't miss too much. But of course, in the overworld here, the tearing, kind of like in Pokemon Emerald, but not nearly as bad, I think, because the everything moves a little bit quicker. It's definitely there and pretty evident, though. Here as well. Kind of a disappointment, but I never really play Final Fantasy on my Game Boy, so it didn't really affect me that much. Of course, it looks just fine right here. Which, I mean, same thing with Pokemon, it looks just fine in battles. But such is life, I guess. Oh, but see, here's the text box. You tilt it up because the screen is not right up against the lens. So yeah, I'd say this is specifically Final Fantasy V. I imagine 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 are pretty similar. I haven't actually checked them out yet. But this is one of the worst games. I still think Pokemon's a little bit worse than this. Or at least Emerald specifically. But you can still see that same effect, and it's still not fantastic. The other games so far were completely fine, aside from that one time Operation C crash, but I don't know. That seems. That might have just been a coincidence. Yeah, this game's super boring. Unless you're getting into it, I suppose, but I'm not, so. There's Final Fantasy V. That was interesting. There it goes. By the way, this high-resolution screen does no favors for that title card. Oh dear. I don't want to do this right now, I just want to get into the game. Heard you like Pikachu's. Will all be Knuckle. Oh, shit. Fuck off, Pikachu. I mean, I didn't say that out loud, did I? What's that? Caterpie stuck in a well. So, yeah. Same thing as the other games, really. Other games being like Pokemon Emerald or Final Fantasy. I'd say compared to Final Fantasy and Pokemon Emerald, though, this is the most minor. Especially when you're zooming through the levels. Because everything moves so fast you don't even notice it. Obviously, when nothing's moving, there's no tearing, or at least no perceptible tearing. But yeah. There's that. I've never played this game on Game Boy Advance. This looks, this is something else here. How do you get in a car? Can I just get in a car? Hey, no? I don't know. Apparently I got a RTFM here. Used to play the shit out of this game on PlayStation, man. Could you only take parked cars and driver, though? Genuinely don't know what to do. I'm sorry, guys. It's too much hassle to, too much effort, really, to go look up what the hell I'm supposed to do. How to play this stupid game. Because I'm never going to play this game. And you know what? Just on foot, it does look fine. There's no perceptible tearing that I can see. So, there. You can go ahead and laugh at me. Because I don't know how to play this game. So, here's something interesting. Goodness, this game plays like shit. So this is apparently a Neo Geo Pocket emulator, and for what it's worth, it's no real tearing, but I played this game on my Neo Geo Pocket Color, and it's got some slowdown, but it runs significantly better than this, but I suppose that's just emulator overhead and an issue there, but I mean, if you want to play some Neo Geo games on your GBA, there you go. Let's see what else is on here. Whatever the hell same game is. I don't recall that. Yeah, Yeah, I'm already bored, and based on how smooth that stuff is moving over, I'm guessing we're gonna have similar performance issues. Oh, go figure, there it goes. One weird thing about the Neo Geo is that this is A and that's B. So when it says press A on screen, you have to press B on the Game Boy. I don't know what the hell I'm doing. Oh, wait. I've played this before. Doesn't mean I'm any good at it, but I've played it before. Didn't know that's what it was called. I'm guessing it's not supposed to run this way either. But I don't actually have this on Neo Geo Pocket, so I can't really compare. Alright, well, I think that's enough for this evening. If you guys want me to check out any other games, let me know. I'll try and make some time to do so. Otherwise, I'm gonna go ahead and get these videos compiled and start queuing them for upload. I've got another video uploading right now, so I'll have to wait till that's done. But hopefully these should be up by Friday morning. And yeah, like I said, if there are any other games y'all want me to check out, let me know. I do have an Easy Flash Omega, so if I don't actually have the physical cartridge, I can try and run it on that. But I do actually have quite a few games, so. But otherwise, I also do have a EverDrive GBX7, so if I don't have the physical Game Boy or Game Boy Color game, I can check it out that way as well. But if you guys noticed something I didn't, then feel free to let me know. Otherwise, have a good night. See you next time.